Our mandate is to make a very quick assessment of the impact of this coronavirus on the economy.
Assess situation and advise government on the next line of action. President Buhari tells five-man committee on impact of coronavirus on the Nigerian economy.
It is my duty, therefore, to announce a new case of coronavirus disease in Nigeria.
Nigeria confirms second case of coronavirus. Now the victim is at the isolation center in Lagos. Aminu Ado Bayero becomes the 15th Fulani Emir of Kano, following the dethronement of Emir Muhammadu Sanusi II.
The Senate's eventual position will be enriched by the eventual report of this committee.
Senate meets the public on social media bill, and the information minister again seeks support on the broadcast media reforms. Good evening and welcome to the news at 9 on the NTA. I am Muhammad Kudu Abubakar. Reading with me tonight is Michael Olaleye in Lagos and Chinenye Nwoye is in Enugu. Thanks for joining us. Worried over the impact of the coronavirus disease on the Nigeria's economy, President Muhammadu Buhari has constituted a five-man committee to quickly assess the situation and advise the federal government on the next line of action. State House correspondent Adam Musambo reports that the committee is chaired by the Minister of Finance, Budget and National Planning, Zainab Ahmed.
The committee, which has 2 days within which to complete its assignment, comprises the Minister of State, Budget and National Planning, Clement Agba, Minister of State for Petroleum Resources, Timothy Silva, Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Gordon Emefiele, and the Group Managing Director of the NNPC, Mele Kolokeri. Briefing newsmen after a closed-door meeting with President Muhammadu Buhari, Chairman of the Committee and Minister of Finance, Zainab Ahmed, said discussions centered on the dwindling oil fortune as a result of the global pandemic and the best way forward for Nigeria.
Our mandate is to make a very quick assessment of the impact of this coronavirus on the economy, especially as it affects the crude oil price. But it is very clear that we will have to revisit the crude oil benchmark price that we have of $57 per barrel. We have to revisit it and lower the price. Where it will be lowered to is the subject of the work of this committee. What the impact will be on that is that there will be reduced revenues to the budget, and it will mean cutting the size of the budget. The quantum of the cut is what we are supposed to assess as a committee.
The Minister of State for Petroleum Resources, Timothy Silva, said apart from the coronavirus disease, the volatility in the oil market is also attributable to the disagreement between Saudi Arabia and the Russian Federation, which he said Nigeria is not in a position to intervene.
We believe that in the coming days, when all of us begin to see the effect of the reduction of prices, OPEC and OPEC Plus might need to meet again and reconsider our position. Meanwhile, we expect also a lot of discussions going on at the level of Saudi Arabia and Russia. But as Nigeria, we are not in a position to begin to engage members on this matter.
The committee is to submit its report to the president on or before Wednesday morning, after which the far-reaching measures to be taken by the federal government will be made public. From the State House, Adam Musambu, NTA News.
Given the current global outbreak of the coronavirus and its potential of causing significant disruptions to health services in the country, as well as impacting negatively on the economy, President Muhammadu Buhari has set up a presidential task force for the control of the coronavirus 19 disease, otherwise known as COVID-19, with the Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Boss Mustafa, as chairman, while Dr. Sani Aliyu is the national coordinator. A statement by Garba Shehu, Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity, also includes the Ministers of Health, Interior, Aviation, Humanitarian Affairs, Education, Information, Environment, and the Directors General of the Department of State Services, Center for Disease Control, and the representative of the World Health Organization as members. The statement adds that the group is expected to deliver its report within the period of 6 months. Another case of coronavirus has been confirmed by the Minister of Health, Dr. Osagie Ehanere. The new case is one of the contacts of the index case under isolation. The Minister of Health disclosed this at a media briefing at the University of Benin Teaching Hospital, Obehi Otobo Apresai has the report.
The minister says although the 60 persons under isolation in Lagos and Ogun states have remained free of the COVID-19 symptoms, the Federal Ministry of Health, in line with best practices, tested all those in isolation and coronavirus was detected in one of them.
It is my duty therefore to announce a new case of coronavirus disease in Nigeria, and the newly confirmed case is an Ogun state contact of the index case, but it has no significant clinical symptoms. This brings the number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in Nigeria today. The newly confirmed case in Nigeria is not a new importation, but a contact of the index case who has since been in isolation and was under clinical follow-up. He presently still does not have any clinical symptoms and is comfortable, and he is being sent to the infectious disease hospital in Lagos.
The minister also disclosed that a group of Nigerian scientists has been able to match the strain of the virus from the index case in Nigeria with the virus circulating in Italy and Wuhan, China.
It is the first time this sequencing of this virus has been performed in Africa. The result has been shared with international authorities and the Director General of the World Health Organization has extended congratulations to Nigerian scientists for this achievement.
Immediately after the briefing, the minister inspected and inaugurated some projects in the hospital. In Benin, Obehi Otobo Apresai, NTA News.
The second coronavirus patient will begin treatment at the infectious disease hospital Yaba, Lagos. This follows his transfer from the isolation center in Iwekuru, Ogun State. Lagos State Commissioner for Health, Professor Akin Abayomi, disclosed this during the daily media briefing on the coronavirus update in the state. Joyken Agbakoya has details.
From Ogun State is the first transmission case of coronavirus in Nigeria. He is among the 40 persons who had close contact with the index case and has been in isolation for more than 10 days.
Now, the good news is that we had the individual under surveillance. So that significantly minimizes the chance of transmission to a large number of people. I, in consultation with Mr. Governor, agreed that we will receive this second patient at our Yaba facility, where we have the appropriate infrastructure, and we have the appropriate trained staff, and we have all the necessary equipment to manage dangerous infections.
Giving an update on the Italian index case, Professor Abayomi says he is in a stable condition but still secreting the virus. The commissioner says the search for two male individuals who arrived in Nigeria with the index case is on. He is appealing to them to come forward to get tested to be sure they are coronavirus free. In Lagos, Joyken Abakoya, NTA News.
Joining me now is Director General, National Center for Disease Control, NCDC, Dr. Chike Ihekwere. Dr. Ihekwere, welcome to our studios. Welcome to our studios.
Thank you.
The confirmation of the second case appears to have now jolted Nigerians. Mm-hmm. So what can you tell us about what Nigerians should now be doing or should be thinking with an increase now in the discovery of a second case?
Thank you. So I think it's very important for Nigerians to understand that there's no new case out of the blue that has come into Nigeria. What has happened is, with every case, the government strategy is one we call contact tracing. One of our key strategies in controlling an outbreak is identifying all the contacts of the index case, listing them, following them up every day, and in some instances testing them to see if the transmission has happened. So this individual was actually one of the contacts of the index case, and we followed up clinically. Initially, at some point, we decided it was appropriate to test the contacts just to be sure. And we were surprised to find one of the contacts had, we confirmed this virus in one of the contacts. The individual himself is asymptomatic. He doesn't have symptoms, which is not unusual with this particular new virus, because we know that people are still able to transmit even when they don't have symptoms. So in a way, this is not a surprise. It's part of the response. It's actually an indication that our public health response is working, and we're able to pick up these cases before they go back into the community. Because the danger is, if we didn't find him, discharged him, he went back into the community and transmitted. So this is actually a sign of success, not a sign of failure.
So what is the, can you tell us about the condition of the index case now? And of course, the second person that tested positive to the virus.
So the index case is doing very well. He's recovering. Like we said, he always had mild symptoms. In fact, he didn't have respiratory symptoms by the time he was admitted. That escalated while he was there. Now he's recovering nicely, and we're looking forward to a full recovery. And like I said, the new case is actually much better, actually doesn't have symptoms at all. So either he's one of those we call the asymptomatics, or he's has very mild, he might develop mild symptoms. So he's being observed now. They're both in the hospital in Lagos. They're being well looked after by our colleagues. In fact, they're getting the best care possible. I know it's difficult for people to be in a hospital environment, but the Lagos State Government is really working very hard to make sure that they're comfortable where they are.
We are told you just came out of the 14 days stipulated period for self-isolation, having come back from China, and what can you tell us of the what you went through, and what will you advise Nigerians who happen to find themselves in a similar situation like yours to do?
Yeah, so my situation was a bit unique. You know, I wasn't in China for commercial or business purposes. I was actually privileged to be one of a high-level delegation by the leader of the World Health Organization to go and understand the response that happened in China and use that to advise the rest of the world, advise WHO, and advise our own government. So that was done fairly successfully. We've learned a lot from the response in China. You will see that the cases in China are rapidly declining. So they must have done something right. That is the evidence the rest of the world is now using. So, yes, our advice to all Nigerians was, if you do go to one of the countries with sustained community transmission, to self-isolate for 14 days. So even though I think my risk was close to zero, I still had to showing example and doing what we preach.
How did it feel being in isolation for 14 days?
Well, to be honest, I was working throughout the period. You know, yes, I was at home and I was in my own room and had to limit contact with the external environment. But these days, with technology, with Zoom, I was in full communication with my team every single day, and we managed to sustain a response.
Finally, what can you tell Nigerians to do so that this COVID-19 disease or epidemic does not spread beyond what it is now in this moment?
So there are two things I'll say, really. The first thing is, please, you know, reduce the amount of panic. We're doing our very best. There's never been a mobilization of the health sector like is happening. The Honorable Minister himself is leading the response, and we're all fully mobilized to do this. The other thing is, there's no better moment to do some of the things we should be doing every day. You know, wash our hands carefully, carry out hand hygiene, do what we call respiratory etiquette. So when you blow your nose or you sneeze, use a tissue, throw it away. If you don't have a tissue, go into your elbows and just make sure there's a certain level of respectable social distancing with the people around you.
Dr. Eheo Kwazu, Director General, National Center for Disease Control, thank you so much for your time. with a sustained effort to stop the spread of COVID-19 virus in the country. Correspondent Doyin Dia has this update on how the various state governments are responding to the epidemic.
From Lafia, Nasarawa State's capital, correspondent Grace Akwe Gotip reports that Nasarawa State government has dedicated two centers in Kefi and Lafia, while all the measures of equipping primary health care centers up to the tertiary level is receiving attention to check coronavirus outbreak. Doris Olumoko reports from Akure, Ondo State capital, that the state government has declared a state of emergency just as advocacy in curtailing the spread of the coronavirus is heightened at public places like motor parks and markets. And from Calabar comes a report that the Cross River State government has stepped up surveillance and intensified information dissemination in the state. One of such is a collaboration with the Vehicle Inspection Officer Unit to enlighten operators of commercial tricycles in Calabar South local government area.
If the operators are safe, the passengers will probably be safe and customers will be safe.
Similarly, the Jigawa State government has taken its sensitization campaign to schools while concluding plans to also reach border communities in the state to educate the public on preventive measures to take against COVID-19 and other contagious diseases.
Just to continue this sensitization to the media, using radio platform, television, like we're doing now.
Considering the geographical location of Katsina State as one of the major gateway to the Republic of Niger, the state government has embarked on sensitization of its people, particularly the border communities, guide against the spread of the COVID-19 virus in Katsina State.
I'm calling on all good people of Katsina State to maintain high level of personal and environmental hygiene.
From Benue State also comes a report that the state government has directed the Emergency Response Committee on Coronavirus to step up surveillance in rural areas to avoid leaving any part of the state uncovered. Ijoma Ugweke from Port Harcourt, the River State capital, reports that buyers are raising concerns over the inflation of prices of imported goods as the fear of traveling to countries affected by coronavirus heightened.
There's a strong synergy between us in the airport and River State government to ensure quick intervention.
In Abuja, Doyin Dia, NTA News.
When I pause for some messages, the news continues after this timeout. Stay tuned.
Welcome to our wonderful world of data with these incredible new offers from your number one 4G network nationwide. Glow Unlimited.
In consideration of the appeals of organizations that could not partake in the verification exercise that was carried out by the NDDC between January and February 2020 on its activities, projects, and programs, all contractors, consultants, vendors, suppliers, and non-governmental organizations doing business with NDDC who have outstanding claims to projects, programs, or supplies but are yet to participate in the exercise are hereby requested to proceed to the River State Office of the NDDC for verification and their contractual status. They are to appear with three copies, soft copies, and originals for citing of the following documents: letter of awards of contract agreements, interim payment certificates. Please note that all contractors, consultants, and service providers are required to show evidence of compliance with the statutory requirements listed in Section 16(6) of the Public Procurement Act 2007. All documents should be submitted in print and soft copy formats. The continuation of verification exercise will take place at the River State Office of the NDDC between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. from Monday 9th to Friday 20th March 2020. Management announcer.
The leadership of Aero Consultative Forum ACF postpones its 20th anniversary celebration scheduled to hold on the 11th and 12th of March 2020 in Kaduna. The decision was taken following renewed attacks by bandits and terrorists on communities across the north, as well as the threat of the deadly coronavirus. ACF therefore regrets the inconveniences caused its special guests. President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR. General Yakubu Gowon, GCFR, Chairman ACF Board of Patrons. Guest Speaker, Professor Tijani Bande, President of the United Nations General Assembly, Senate President Ahmed Lawan, members of the ACF Board of Patrons, governors of the 19 Northern States, particularly the Governor of Plateau State, and Chairman of Northern State Governors Forum, Simon Bakola Long, as well as the Chief Host, Malan Nasser Ahmed Erufai, the Executive Governor of Kaduna State, including traditional rulers and chiefs. A new date will be announced in due course. Announcer, Senator Aliumaga Takadawa Amaku, Chairman, Organizing Committee.
On behalf of the Governing Council, the Director General, Chief Executive of the Industrial Training Fund, Sir Joseph N. Ari, cordially invites policymakers, technocrats, captains of industry, skills acquisition experts, and other stakeholders to the first National Skills Summit, theme, Skills for Employability and Job Creation. Vice President Professor Yemi Osinbajo, special guest, Honorable Minister, Federal Minister of Industry, Trade and Investment, Otumba Richard Adeniyi Adebayo, distinguished guest. The Honorable Minister of State, Federal Minister of Industry, Trade and Investment, Ambassador Miriam Yalwaji Katagum, will be the chairperson at the event. Papers during the event will be presented by the Executive Secretary, Tertiary Education Trust Fund, Professor Suleiman Elias Bogoro, Director General, Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Muda Yusuf. Date, Thursday 12th March 2020, time 9 a.m. Venue, Ladikwali Hall, Sheraton Hotels and Towers, Abuja. Guests are expected to be seated by 8:30 a.m. please. ITF Management Announcer.
You can choose to manage everything else, but not your data. Get more out of life with the new Airtel data plans. Dial *141# today. Data is life.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
Banter better with Coca-Cola and stand a chance to win an all-expense-paid trip to the UK to watch a live Premier League game or your share of 400 million naira in instant cash prizes. Simply buy a bottle of Coke or Coke Zero. Look under the cap for your unique code and dial *4255*55* your unique code # to stand a chance to win. The more Coke you buy, the better your chances of winning. See pack labels and posters for more details. Promo starts March 1st and ends May 31st.
National Sports Festival. Yay! Edo 2020, the heartbeat of the nation.
This March, the heartbeat of Nigeria, Edo State, welcomes all 36 states and the FCT to the 20th National Sports Festival, Edo 2020. Get ready for the greatest sporting event ever hosted in Nigeria from the 22nd of March to the 1st of April. As the best athletes from across the nation showcase their sporting talent in 39 exciting sports. And in the spirit of the games, His Excellency, President Muhammadu Buhari, will light the festival torch at the opening ceremony that will take place at the newly refurbished Samuel Abumadia Stadium, Benin City. The chief host of the festival is His Excellency, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, the governor of Edo State. Edo is ready. It's game time.
Maybe see now today or 4 days when my girls won't come visit, and I need to go expire.
Oh, but my guys, they can't follow me. Watch this match. I must not fold the hand. Hey!
Every long.
What's happened now?
Sorry to disappoint you, but my subscription don't expire.
The match is not on my GoTV package.
Now, you all be that.
I beg, give me your phone.
I show you how you go take Dua for my GoTV app for your phone.
Life is so much easier with my GoTV app. Make payments, clear error messages, change your package. You can also check your due dates and keep abreast of your payment history. The new My GoTV app is everything you need in one place. So what are you waiting for? Download My GoTV app now from Google Play or App Store to enjoy the easy life. GoTV. Live it, love it.
Welcome back. Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje has approved the appointment of Aminu Ado Bayero as the new Emir of Kano. This followed his nomination by a four-member Kingmakers Committee of the Kano Emirate Council. Abdullahi Mustafa reports that Chairman Kano Alhaji Nasir Ado Bayero, who is the younger brother of Emir Aminu Ado Bayero, is now the Emir of Bechi.
I have been directed by His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Kano State, Dr. Abdullahi Umar Ganduje, OFR, based on the powers conferred on him by the provision of Section 11, Subsection 1 of the Kano State Emirate Council Law 2019, that is equivalent to Hijra 1441, to announce the appointment of Alhaji Amina Ado Bayero, the former Emir of Bichi Emirate, as the new Emir of Kano.
60-year-old Amina Ado Bayero is the second son of late 13th Fulani ruler of Kano Alhaji Ado Bayero. The 1984 graduate of Mass Communications from Bayero University, Kano, Aminu also holds a master's degree in business administration. Subsequently, he trained and worked as a commercial pilot till the early 1990s when he was turbaned Dammaji by his late father, Alhaji Ado Bayero. From that period to May last year when he was appointed Emir of Bichi, Aminu held various other titles including Damburam, Traki, Sarkin Dawakin Sakargida, and Wambai. He succeeded Muhammad Sanusi II, who was deposed following allegations of disloyalty and violation of some provisions of new Kano Emirate law amended by the state government. Sanusi has been on the throne since June 2014. He succeeded the 13th Fulani Emir, Alhaji Ado Bayero. Muhammad Sanusi II served as the governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria between 2009 and 2014. In Kano, Abdullahi Mustafa, NTA News.
Still in Kano, the mood at the Emir of Kano's palace was tense. This follows the removal of the Emir of Kano, Muhammad Sanusi II, by the Kano State Executive Council. Elizabeth Gila Lamido reports that the main entrance to the palace was also barricaded.
The announcement of the dethronement of Emir Muhammad Sanusi II did not stop any business activities in the ancient city of Kano. Security operatives had been deployed to strategic areas of the town and adjoining roads to the Emir's palace and Kano State Government House. At the Kano Emir's palace, NTA News observed that people were calm while others were reacting to the new development. According to tradition, any deposed Emir must leave the state before the pronouncement of another. And so was the case of Muhammad Sanusi II, who has been banished to Nasarawa State. His grandfather, Sir Muhammad Sanusi I, was ruled Kano between 1954 to 1963, was also banished to Azare in Bauchi State 57 years ago. Lawal Salo Inua, NTA News.
That was Laos Law Inua, not Elizabeth Yila Lamido. Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed has again called on members of the Electronic Media Content Owners Association of Nigeria, MQAN, to support the ongoing reforms in the broadcast industry in Nigeria. Minister made the call at a meeting with members in Lagos. Anthony Forson reports.
Members of the Electronic Media Content Owners Association of Nigeria are radio, television and online content producers who showcase contents like drama, soap series, entertainment, musical programs, talk shows, sports and magazine programs. Their meeting with the Information and Culture Minister is to throw their weight behind the ongoing reforms in the broadcast industry. It is in line with this mission that the Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed was quick to place on their doorsteps the need for them to double their efforts in a bid to catch up with modernity.
The sheer scope of content available to us with a lot of hard work and research, you can get first-class content out of the rich history of our country.
Of particular interest, the minister said, content segmentation to suit particular audience is of immense importance.
I think we can concentrate on children programming. We need more and more of children programming. We need more of women programming because they are the ones that watch the contents most.
From the broadcast regulator to the content owners, they all applauded the minister's resilience in reforming the broadcast space, acknowledging that players in the industry will be better for it in the end. In Lagos, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
The Protection from Internet Falsehood and Manipulations Bill introduced by the Ninth Senate in 2019 has continued to receive disquiet from across many persons across the country. This further resonated at the public hearing on the bill convened by the Senate Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters. National Assembly correspondent Ignatius Sunko reports.
In November 2019, the social media bill sponsored by Senator Sani Musa was introduced in the Senate. A few weeks later, the bill was passed through second reading and referred to the Senate Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters for public hearing. Since then, the bill has been in the eye of the storm, but the Senate promised of providing a forum where members of the public would make their positions known. Indeed, at this Senate conference room, the bill was thrown up for input from civil society organizations, ministries, departments and agencies of government, members of the diplomatic corps, security agencies and media organizations, including the Nigerian Television Authority. The Senate gave further explanations on the bill.
For a legal framework to regulate and control the use of internet and its intermediaries in the transmission of information in Nigeria.
National security is one factor that must be taken into consideration.
The Senate's eventual position will be enriched by the eventual report of this committee.
The Nigerian Army, Nigerian Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs and the Civil Waters Coalition described the bill as a necessity.
We want to say that we welcome this bill for reasons of national security.
Pass it in such a manner that it will not guide freedom of speech.
But the Nigerian Union of Journalists, Policy and Legal Advocacy Center, the Nigerian Communications Commission and Broadcasting Organization of Nigeria affirmed their positions.
News is worse than coronavirus, no doubt. But the people should not be stopped from expressing themselves.
And evidently, it goes to show that there are existing laws which can deal with such issues.
Chairman, our view is that those laws that exist at this time need to be looked at.
It's also the data protection bill which has been submitted for consideration.
With this, Senate will now await the report of the committee at plenary for consideration. From the National Assembly, Ignatius Nkwo, NTA News.
Well, the Buhari Media Organization says the Social Media Regulation Bill was sponsored by a private member and not an executive bill. This clarification becomes necessary in view of a statement credited to the presiding bishop of Living Faith Church Worldwide, also known as Winners Chapel, Bishop David Oyedepo, for tagging the President Muhammadu Buhari's administration as the worst in the history of Nigeria, and that the days of the administration are numbered. A statement premised on the introduction of the Social Media Regulation Bill. Comments the group observes that should have been directed to the legislature and not President Buhari. The organization describes the clergyman's position as a view fueled by his lingering bitterness over Nigeria's rejection of his preferred candidates at the 2019 presidential election, Atiku Abubakar. A statement by its chairman, Nii Akinsuju, says BMO regrets the partisan role of the clergy who ordinarily should be playing fatherly and advisory roles. The National Working Committee of the All Progressives Congress, APC, has not been factionalized or in the nature of any crisis been repeatedly reported in a section of the media. The party's National Publicity Secretary, Larry Issa Onilu, in a statement observes that a political organization such as the APC, contestations are not unusual and are not necessarily intractable. The issues being alluded to in some media reports are matters before the courts and should be allowed to run their normal and legal course. The party spokesman called on members of the National Working Committee and the party's secretariat staff to resume at their offices and continue carrying out their scheduled roles and responsibilities without any fear. The APC has commended the Inspector General of Police, Mohammed Abubakar Adamu, personnel of the Police Department of the State Services and other security services for their professionalism in the process of maintaining the peace and preventing hoodlums from fomenting trouble at the APC National Secretariat. The statement assured all APC members in Nigeria and across the world that leaders of the party are capable of resolving any contestations that may arise, bearing in mind the best interests of its members and in the pursuit of progress and development of Nigeria. Victims of the recent bandits' attack in five villages of Kaduna State have received relief materials donated by the wife of the president and First Lady Hajia Aisha Muhammadu Buhari through her pet project, Future Assured. Muhammad Umar Ajingi has details.
Still in pains and shock, these are victims of attacks by bandits on Kerawa village. Sanusia, who escaped with a bullet wound, lives in this house with 10 of his children.
I have so many children and there is no food in the house.
Help has arrived for the victims as the First Lady Hajia Aisha Muhammadu Buhari donates relief materials to them. The items were handed over on her behalf by the Executive Secretary, Kaduna State Emergency Management Agency, Memuna Abubakar.
The essence of bringing these items is to tell the community that the government is with them.
Normalcy is gradually returning to the communities barely a week after the attack. In Kaduna, I am Muhammad Umar Ajingi, NTA News.
In another development, the Nigerian Air Force says the Air Task Force of Operation Lafia Dole has destroyed an Islamic State of West Africa province hideout and neutralized some of their fighters at Mina along the Gulumba-Gana-Kumshe axis in the northern part of Borno State. In a statement by the NAF Director of Public Affairs, Public Relations and Information, Air Commodore Ibikunle Daramola, the mission, which was executed on 4th March 2020 as part of the ongoing Operation Decisive Edge, was undertaken after a Nigerian Air Force intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance aircraft spotted the terrorists assembling in the vicinity of some compounds within the settlement. Fighter jets scrambled by the ATF to engage the location scored accurate hits in the target area, leading to the destruction of some terrorist structures as well as the neutralization of some of their fighters. The Nigerian Air Force says, in furtherance of the objective of restoring peace and security in the Northeast and operating in concert with surface forces, it will continue to carry out air interdiction missions against the enemies of Nigeria. Chief of the Air Staff and Air Marshal Sadiq Baba Abubakar says the Nigerian Air Force will increase the number of fighting forces at its 271 detachment unit in Bernangwari Axis of Kaduna State to further tackle insecurity in the area. The Chief of the Air Staff stated this during the inauguration of 20 by one accommodation facility for air personnel deployed to the unit. Suleiman Abdullahi Rigakuchikon has the report.
So we are very grateful to Chief of Air Staff for his efforts. We know that you are doing your best. We know you are one of the best we have in this country, and we shall continue to pray for you.
A testimony of the result of effort and commitment of the Chief of the Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Baba Abubakar, who was in Birnin Ngwari to inaugurate additional social amenities for the fighting forces deployed to the area. 271 Detachment is one of the 13 units provided by the Air Force in the last 4 years. The construction of the 20 flats of one block of 20 rooms by works personnel of the force, Chief of the Air Staff Air Marshal Sadiq Baba Abubakar says, will facilitate deployment of more troops and equipment to fight banditry in the area and neighboring communities.
The Nigerian Air Force is constantly reviewing tactics, techniques and procedures, as well as in placing additional measures to effectively add value to the operations we are conducting.
For the people, it is a sign of new things to happen as they look forward to a robust strategy to tackling banditry, kidnapping and other crimes in the Axis. In Kaduna, I am Suleiman Abdullahi Rigachikun, NTA News.
To the judiciary now, the Court of Appeal Abuja Division has requested that the Federal Capital Territory High Court remit the original case file in relation to the appeal filed by the senator representing Anambra South, Ifeanyi Ubah, of the Young Progressive Party to the Court of Appeal within 48 hours. Justice Steve Adah of the Court of Appeal gave the order Monday while hearing preliminary application on the motion filed by Ifeanyi Ubah appealing the 11th of April 2019 judgment of the lower court, which sacks him from the Senate. Vera Chinguba has more.
The order requesting the FCT High Court to bring to the Court of Appeal the original court file on the 11th of April 2019 judgment of the court became necessary following some irregularities, misrepresentation of facts, and the signing of complementary record of appeal instead of the original. The file is expected to reach the Court of Appeal within 48 hours. The respondent's counsel, however, did not oppose the request. The FCT High Court had, in its judgment, sacked Ifeanyi Ubah for allegedly submitting a forged National Examination Council certificate to INEC in support of his nomination as a candidate for February 23, 2019 senatorial election, and ordered INEC to withdraw certificate of return issued to YPP candidate. When the FCT High Court declined Ubah's request to set aside his 11th April judgment, he filed another suit in which Justice Taiwo Taiwo of FCT High Court gave an order restraining INEC from issuing certificate of return to Obinna Ozor of PDP. Further hearing continues on the 12th of March. In Abuja, Viera Chumuba, NTA News.
We'll have more reports now as we join Michael in Lagos. Michael, over to you.
Thank you, Kudu, and welcome. The Standards Organization of Nigeria, SON, is among seven agencies expelled from the CPOs in the wake of the implementation of the presidential order on the ease of doing business, with the African Continental Free Trade Agreement likely to increase the volume of importation. The Senate Committee on Industries is concerned about the influx of fake and substandard products and is calling for the reinstatement of the agency. Nigeria loses 15 trillion naira to fake and substandard products annually and is ranked one of the world's highest markets for the importation of uncertified goods. The ports, whether land, sea or air, are the entry points for sizable volume of these fake items. And the Chairman Senate Committee on Industries is optimistic that with the return of the Standards Organization of Nigeria, SON, to the CPOs, the country may likely save 50% of this huge amount.
There must be a seat, an office for you to sit with the customs, to know what is going on. The same thing happens to Sugar Council. I'm sorry to say this. You are bringing in something. You don't have office to checkmate what comes in. How do you determine what goes out? So I think the legislator will look into that and amend it where it is necessary.
Using the manufacturing industry to stimulate the pace of economic growth is a core mandate that must be achieved. And this oversight function is to assess the level of work done by SON at ensuring that quality products get into the country.
We are leading other African countries in harmonization and breaking of trade barriers. Our lab, we have about 40 labs here, about 8 of them are accredited, then 20 undergoing accreditation at the same time to position them in readiness for the continental free trade.
In the wake of implementing guidelines for the takeoff of the African Continental Free Trade Agreement, standard is sacred. Inadequate training of journalists on election coverage, conflict reporting, hate speech, and delayed voter education have been identified as some of those areas the media organizations must lay much emphasis on in order to realize credible coverage of elections in Nigeria. This was at a two-day retreat on National Broadcasting Commission, NBC, Broadcasting Organizations of Nigeria, BON, Post-Election Lessons Learned, organized by the Institute of Media and Society in collaboration with the European Union support to democratic governance in Nigeria. Today's IQ report.
The two-day retreat for media organizations is aimed at reviewing the performance of the media and the regulators during the last general elections in the country. It is also to enable them to project further on how subsequent elections should be handled to develop the country's democratic experience. The Acting Director General NBC, Professor Armstrong Edachaba, says when adequate preparations are made based on the findings of the previous elections, appropriate outcome will be realized.
We expect that year after year, election after election, the media should improve in delivering on its mandate of facilitating an enlightened, civilized, fair and justiciable electoral process.
Other speakers noted that the role of the media in electioneering is key to the reinforcement of democracy through peaceful, credible, fair and transparent election process.
We need to move fast so that our concerns, the concerns of this industry, are taken care of in this review process.
We want reforms in the industry professionally so that all of us will be able to look on the other side and then hold on to what we generally refer to as the fourth estate of the realm, that we're going to hold the other three accountable for their actions, for their or their inactions.
The retreat had in attendance officials of broadcast media regulators, practitioners, and other key players in the industry. In Lagos, Tunde Saiki, NTA News.
And those are the stories trending at this hour in Lagos. Network News continues after this break. Please stay tuned.
Distribue les swings et les uppercuts, ça fait, ça fait, et ça fait, ou bien, ou parfois même, viens petite fille dans mon comic strip, viens faire des bulles, viens faire des,
What we are really cultivating here is a better future for all Nigerian women, and it's not always easy. Panadol Extra relieves headache, backache, joint pain, toothache, and menstrual pain. The pain is worth it.
Stopping the kids from playing stops the learning. That's why we stop the germs.
Indeed, Safeguard fights against germs. Safeguard removes 99% of germs.
Malta Guinness is packed with B vitamins to fuel your greatness.
This is beautiful.
Quality is vital. Quality is Vita Foam.
Hello, honey.
Hey, baby.
Wow. Those
those guys are good in bed.
What?
Yes, we're good in bed. Hurry now to any Vitafoam accredited dealer nationwide or visit us online on www.vitafoamng.com to place your order today. Vitafoam, the fine art of living.
Channel where you watch just now, don't work, huh? No panic.
Then say me no panic.
You go do it by yourself like ABC. Oh yeah, press the menu button on top your remote. Scroll up and down till you see Information Central. Then press OK.
Press OK.
Check the signal strength and quality. If the signal strength and quality pass 70, make you press the exit button, go back. Go advanced options, then choose installation, then go to reset and press OK.
Yeah, press OK.
Wow, now you self fit catch all those channels with the one miss road by yourself. Yes, make your groove for no loss. You see as I do, Abi?
And I see as I do, am.
Go TV, live it, love it.
And I see as we do, am.
Welcome back to our Abuja studios. Investors lose 329 naira as the NSE ASI dips by minus 2.41% to open the week negative. Amina Najan is here with details on business news. Welcome.
Thank you, Mohammed. Nigeria has recorded its first quarterly trade deficit since July of 2016, as the value of its export fell by 9.79% in the fourth quarter of 2019, while imports rose by 37.2%. The latest foreign trade in goods report released by the National Bureau of Statistics indicates that the value of the nation's total trade rose by 10.15% to 10.12 trillion naira in the fourth quarter of 2019 over the value recorded in the third. A further breakdown shows that export components dropped by 9.79% to 4.77 trillion naira, while the import component increased to 5.35 trillion naira, all against the third quarter.
To look at what we are going to export, agricultural product, organic materials that we have in abundance, organic food and all that, that is in high demand abroad. And not only that, we have the human resource capacity. We have begin to export of human resource. And then so that in after Nigerians will be taking position, we are heading the African Development Bank. This is where our bank should rally around.
And finally, the Nigerian Stock Exchange has reacted to global trends that sent the O-share index falling more than 2% at noon this Monday. The investors lost 329.39 billion naira at the close of business to open the week negative. The O-share index lost a total of 2.14% to finish at 25,647.54 points. Market capitalization ended the day's session at 13.365 trillion naira. Volume of trade was 185 million, valued at 1.825 billion naira in 2,690 deals. Most sought-after stocks were led by the banking sector: Zenith Bank, Transnational Corporation, and Guarantee Trust Bank. And that's the size of the business package. Mohammed, back to you.
Thank you, Amina. President Muhammadu Buhari's resolve to remove 1 million Nigerians out of poverty is coming to fruition as another set of 1,500 women and youths in Kebbi State have been empowered with 10,000 naira loan each to start or improve their businesses. Nura Tankwe Wakili has the report.
Hawao Galadima, Hadiza Bala and Aisha Bello Jafeji are among thousands of women in Kebbi State whose small beginning is expected to be translated into prosperity after accessing the microloan of 10,000 naira payable in 3 years with a 2 month maturity period.
And the payment rate is just 233 naira. We are not taking this money from Kebbi State or any other emirate. By the time you give this 1,500, if they start paying, we want
This loan is coming at no better time than now, when Argungu Town in Kebbi State will be playing host to thousands of visitors for the Argungu International Fishing and Cultural Festival, as the beneficiaries are presented with another opportunity to explore their enterprise.
My people will need to eat and drink. The opportunity offered them by this soft loan is going to be amplified.
It is an expansion of the support package that President Muhammadu Buhari has authorized the National Directorate of Employment to be given across the nation.
There was also a formal inauguration of Said King Kabin Argungu Education Foundation, where thousands of books and writing materials were provided, courtesy of the Director General National Director of Employment, Dr. Nasir Ladan, a feat that earned him the traditional title of Gado Damasun Kabi by Argungu Emirate Council. In Birnin Kebbi, Nuratan Kwakili, NTA News.
Time now to join Chinaye in Enugu for more reports. Hello, Chinaye. Hello, Chinaye.
Hello, Kudu. Good evening and welcome to Enugu. Equipping the nation's youth with practical skills is a sure path to national growth and development, the Managing Director of Scientific Equipment Development Institute, SEDI, Akuke Enugu State, Professor Samuel Ndubisi, stated this during the closing ceremony of skills acquisition training for 46 youths at the institute. Chika Ugu has the report.
These graduates from various states in the country were exposed to a one-month thorough practical training in various fields of engineering and ICT. Applauding the federal government for its tremendous support to the institute, the managing director said he noted that the institute has continued to train youths from all states in the country to be equipped with practical knowledge to make them useful to themselves and the country at large.
The idea of this training is nothing else other than to bridge the gap between the classwork theories, which we normally receive, and the real-life engineering practice.
Mr. President Muhammadu Buhari, for his initiative to train the youths of this country in skills that will equip them to be more deployable.
Beneficiaries of the program believe that the knowledge acquired will go a long way to improving their lives.
For all the 5 years that I've been calculating in school, I thought it's all about the theory. I had a practical knowledge. Amazingly, coming to this place, my instructors, let me just put it this way, they emptied themselves into us.
The graduates were presented with certificates and empowerment toolkits in Enugu, Chika Ugu, NTA News.
And that is it from Enugu. Network News continues with Kudu in Abuja after this commercial break. Please stay.
On Tuesday Live this week, the National Directorate of Employment, NDE, and Job Creation in Nigeria.
The white collar job is not there. You know, degree or no degree, you use your brain, you use your hands so that you can have something doing, so that you can earn a living.
Tune in Tuesday Live at 10:30 p.m. with those who should know, proffering best practices. Don't miss it.
Up ahead is development from the world of sports.